Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, the Johnny Depp versus Amber Heard case is nearing its end, right? So Johnny Depp's lawyer is cross-examining Amber Heard and is completely destroying her, as you've seen in my previous videos. But today we're going to be looking at a clip where she's specifically targeting Amber Heard's evidence, because if you notice, Amber Heard pretty much has no evidence for any of her claims. All the audio recordings, all the evidence from the witnesses, everything points in Johnny Depp's favor. So what does she have? And apparently we're going to be looking at no evidence of a smashed phone. I don't even know where she mentioned a smashed phone, so this is going to be new.
Your relationship with Mr. Depp began in October of 2011, right?
That's correct.
And you previously testified multiple times, under oath, that the first year of your relationship with Mr. Depp was the best of times, right, Ms. Heard?
I like how she has to remind her you're under oath because, hey, you've literally lied multiple times. At this point, I'm pretty sure it's almost confirmed. Amber Heard is probably going to go to jail for perjury because she's been lying under oath. She's been changing her story left and right. Clearly what's happened is that she's been looking at social media and she's like, oh, I messed up here and I messed up here. Okay, gonna change my story. But unfortunately, it's all recorded, okay?
You testified that as far as you could tell, Mr. Depp was sober that first year.
That is correct. That's what I used to believe.
Keeps looking at the jury. She's so annoying.
Magic.
Yes, I always
answer the lawyer.
God.
But now you've told this jury that Mr. Depp was being violent with you throughout 2012, haven't you, Ms. Heard?
No, he took a break in the middle of 2012 when he was sober.
That he was hitting you in 2012, though. Is that right?
He was hitting me in 2012. He just took a break in the middle.
This sounds so weird. Nobody says take a break.
He did.
And you told them that Mr. Depp was in and out of sobriety in 2012.
That is correct.
You told this jury that, in 2012, I was in the beginning stages of this, just learning these patterns. I was learning that drinking kind of correlated with the violence, end quote. Is that right?
That is correct.
So it was during these cycles of violence in 2012 that you gave Mr. Depp a knife as a gift.
Okay, this lawyer is actually cracked, okay? She's like, and indeed, during these cycles of violence, you thought it would be appropriate to give him a knife as a gift, right? Who gives their abuser a knife, dude? That's the most stupid, like, logic ever, all right? There's Amber Heard completely falls apart. There's so many holes in her case. And the fact that she gifted him a knife, bro, goddamn.
A knife, I think for a birthday present early in our relationship. I believe it was around 2012, but I'm not certain.
Yes. This was definitely before he started beating me. Let me change up the timeline again.
We've seen a picture of that knife, but I think we should bring out the real thing.
Oh, damn. Bringing out the
Master
real
Deputy
guns, baby.
Halusa. Master Deputy Sheriff Halusa. May I please have you show the knife to Ms. Heard?
Damn. Amber, don't grab it. I know you want to. I know you want
to. That's the knife you gave to the man who was hitting
you. Chuck
it
in her direction, but
I wasn't worried he was going to stab me with it when I gave it to him. That's for certain.
But you gave it to him while he was abusing you, allegedly.
I gave it to him that year.
This makes no sense. Why would any gift out of all the gifts in the entire world, you choose a knife? You choose a damn knife to the man who is apparently so violent that you were scared of him? Apparently he was pinning you down, doing all this garbage. I'm not buying it.
Mr. Deputy Sheriff.
You even said at one point that I was afraid I was gonna die.
This is the knife you gave to the man who would get drunk and violent with you, right?
This is the same knife that I gave him as a present in 2012, yes.
Wait, okay, like, the lawyer says one thing, she says something completely different. I mean, yeah, at this point you're just making a fool of yourself. And
now, Ms. Heard, I'm going to need to talk to you about what happened in Australia in March of 2015. You've testified that at some point during the incident you described, you witnessed Mr. Depp bashing a phone against a wall, right?
That is correct.
You testified that the phone was breaking into pieces.
I was watching it disappear.
That Mr. Depp smashed it, I think your word was smithereens.
What is this language? If you see a phone being broken, I was watching it disappear. What kind of language is that? No human being speaks like that. What are you trying to act like? She's trying to act like some philosophical poet who's just above everything. The phone is being broken. If that's what happened, say that's what happened. What are you talking about? I was watching it disappear. What, the parts are just disintegrating into air? What are you talking about?
Yes, that is correct.
And according to your testimony, this was a wall-mounted phone in the bar area.
That is correct.
And you testified that the wall-mounted phone that you saw Mr. Depp smash is on the wall on the left.
That's correct. Mm-hmm. So if you were looking at this picture, the wall-mounted phone would have been behind you on the left-hand side of your shoulder.
But it's not depicted in this photo, correct?
Whoever took this photo was standing right in front of where that mounted phone was.
That's convenient. The pieces of the phone, Mr. Depp, are not shown in this picture either, right?
You don't see it because it's whoever took this photo standing in front of that.
Whoever took this photo, it's Mr. Ben King, correct?
That's what I believe.
Yeah. Mr. King testified under oath in this trial, right?
That is correct.
And he testified that there was no wall-mounted phone smashed to smithereens that he had to replace, correct?
I didn't hear him testify to that, no.
Okay, first off, are you not watching the court case, Amber? Are you not watching your own damn court case? You expect me to believe you are not hearing every single word being uttered? If this is something that is deciding your entire life after this, deciding whether you go to prison, deciding whether you're $50 million in debt, and deciding your entire life, you will be listening to every witness, every single thing. Your ears and eyes are open to everything, and you're like, I didn't hear him testify to that. Shut the hell, you're such a clown. She's lying. And then there's a witness who literally says this never happened. I mean, the only evidence you have is a photo with nothing in it. This is literally hearsay at this point.
He did. Your counsel elicited it.
I disagree with that representation.
You also saw this picture.
Actually, I disagree. Yes, even though it happened. Such
which is also admitted into evidence. And so this is the bar area to the right of the wall-mounted phone you just described.
If you were facing in that direction, okay. If you're facing this direction, it would be behind you.
This phone on the counter isn't the phone that got smashed. So there are two phones in the bar area.
There was a wall-mounted phone. I don't know if it was decorative or what, but it was white, like it looked antique, large and antique.
And what the large and antique one that's not depicted in any photograph, including ones you took, is the one that Mr. Depp damaged, correct?
That is correct. I only took...
The centerpiece of my argument, I never took any pictures of it. Also, a little bit suspicious, two phones in the same room, side by side? That's a bit ridiculous. If a phone's right there on the table, why would there be a wall-mounted phone right there? And even if there was, why didn't you take a picture of it being broken into pieces? Why is the only picture there of nothing? I just don't get it. She has no evidence of anything. For someone who was planning this for so long, I could have faked evidence better than this, man. It's just embarrassing.
Pictures of the mirrors.
So there's no picture of that damaged phone?
I didn't take a picture of it, no.
Okay. So back to the phone
smashing. Basically, I'm lying.
You watched Mr. Depp smash the phone, right?
That's correct. I watched it.
Mr. Depp.
You testified that you were, quote, watching the phone every single time he pulled his hand back. End quote.
That's correct.
And according to you, this is when Mr. Depp lost the tip of his finger,
Mr.
right?
Depp.
It is my best guess. I didn't notice his finger come off, obviously. I was watching him smash the phone and watching the pieces break while he was doing it.
Well, it's not your best guess, Ms. Hurd.
That is my best guess, yes.
Okay, let's go back to my questions. You submitted a declaration under the penalty of perjury in this case. Do you remember that?
That is correct.
Okay, let's look at that declaration.
Under the penalty of perjury, ladies and gentlemen.
I declare, under penalty of perjury, under the laws of the state of Virginia, that the foregoing is true and correct.
That is correct.
And this is dated
so
April
proud 10th, of herself.
2019.
Correct.
Wow, I'm
now
telling the truth, guys.
16,
achievement
which is on
for
page
her.
5. While he was smashing the phone, Johnny severely injured his finger, cutting off the top of it. End quote. Did I read that correctly?
Yes, that's correct.
Wait, didn't you just say you weren't sure what exactly happened to his finger? And also, how would you know when that's not even what... Wait, so you're blatantly lying here under oath. That is... Oh my God, you're digging yourself a deeper and deeper
hole. So you testified in this courtroom that after Mr. Depp smashed the phone, he held you down on the countertop by the neck. Do you remember that?
With his cut-off finger. I'm sure he had... plenty of energy to do that with his cut-off finger. He's holding you down. That's a bit far-fetched.
I'm not quite sure the exact
sequence the other
of
hand?
Things, but yes, both
but
of those things.
Wouldn't if his finger got cut off? Wouldn't he immediately seek medical help instead of trying to hold you down?
Bend.
Well, we'll get to the sequence. And this is when Mr. Depp supposedly assaulted you with a bottle, right?
On the countertop, he assaulted me.
So Mr. Depp was able to get you on the counter, right?
He held me down by my neck.
And hold you down by your neck.
That is correct.
And do this bottle, insert it, and do all of this with his finger cut off? Your story is just falling apart more and more and more. With if a man's finger is cut off, I'm sure it would be pretty hard to do all of this, to be honest. He would be in severe pain. We ain't talking a bruise on the finger. His finger is cut off. He's in severe, insane amount of pain. I don't know how he would be doing any of this. And, oh my god, like, I don't buy it.
According to you, while holding you down by the neck, correct?
So one hand is holding her down, pinning her down. The other hand is grabbing the bottle, you know, the one with the cut off finger, and shoving it up her parts and breaking it inside or something. I don't know.
I'm sorry, can you clarify what you're asking me?
While Mr. Depp is holding you by the neck against the countertop, he grabs the bottle. That's your testimony.
No, those two things didn't happen at the exact same time, no.
So he's holding the bottle? Is that your testimony?
While holding
you down by the neck?
Sorry. What was your question?
Oh my god, you're so
annoying. Your testimony
annoying.
Is, Ms. Heard, that either he has the bottle before or after he's holding you by the neck on the counter. Is that your testimony?
He held me by the neck on the counter.
Where's the bottle?
She's just wasting time. She wants this to be over. She's just like, I'm just gonna ignore the entire question, despite her repeating it three times. Ridiculous, dude.
While holding you down by your neck.
When he was assaulting me with the bottle, it was in his hand.
Okay. Was it in his hand before or after he holds you down by your neck?
I was being held down while he assaulted me with the bottle.
When he puts you on the counter, does he have the bottle in his hand, yes or no?
As I have always said, I don't remember exactly what happened first.
Okay, basically, she's trying not to get caught on the fact that Johnny Depp is using both of his hands at the same time, right? Amber's not realizing this, but the lawyer's saying, hey, he's probably not using both hands at the same time, considering one of them has a cut-off finger. Now, Amber is trying to dodge around this, but clearly her story isn't lining up.
First, I don't remember the sequence. I just remember being aware that I was being assaulted by a bottle while I was on the countertop.
So this bottle. But you don't know how he got the bottle, right?
That is correct.
And he did.
Okay. Both holding a woman down by the, like, with your only hand, that requires a lot of force. Moreover, using your other hand to hold a bottle and assault someone in their private part and shove it up and do whatever the hell with this bottle is ridiculous. Like, both have extreme amount of assertions on both hands. So I don't believe that he did this, missing a goddamn thing, like a part of his finger. That's so unbelievable.
That right after he lost the tip of his right middle finger.
Again, I don't remember the exact
middle
sequence
finger, that's
of those
so,
events.
Like, you
we'll
can't
get to
hold
sequence.
Anything. If,
and
this
while he
is
was
gone.
On 8 to 10 MDMA pills, right?
Yes.
Let's talk about the sequence. This is the sequence of events you testified to in this courtroom. That he smashed the phone to smithereens, and then assaulted you, lost the tip of his finger, and then assaulted you with a bottle. Yes? That's the sequence of events that you testified to in this courtroom.
To be clear, you're putting it in order when you say words like, then. I have never claimed that I can remember the exact sequence of these things. This was a multi-day assault that took place over three horrible days.
Ms. Heard,
the worst thing ever happened to me.
That's not my question.
Okay, the multi-day assault. All right.
My question isn't about the three
well,
day.
Well, okay, apparently this entire thing happened. I mean, clearly when you were being held down and the bottle is happening, that's an hour long event or a half an hour or whatever, however long it lasted. That's not a multi-day event when he was breaking the phone. Is he breaking the phone for the entire day? That's so dumb, Amber. Okay, listen, it's pretty evident at this point that this incident didn't occur at all, okay? And we all know how Johnny actually lost his finger. Johnny's story makes 10 times more sense than smashing this telephone. There's no pictures of, there's no proof that this telephone even existed, which was right next to another telephone mounted on the wall. Why would there be two right next to each other? Makes no sense. Second, there's no pictures of anything. Third, the only picture is of nothing. And fourth, Amber can't even recount the sequence of events. And five, Johnny Depp was using both of his hands, multitasking like an absolute savage with his middle finger cut off. The amount of things that have to line up for Amber's story to be true is astronomical. This is like dream cheating chances, you know, 1 in 7.5 trillion. Let's get, okay, Amber, you're lying, come on.